Hello everyone, I will show you the best WordPress cache plugin. So you know, a cache plugin is really useful when your host or your server is slow. I don't have like much resources. And also it's better to use cache because it increases the speed of your site. That's why it's a cache plugin or a cache feature. If you're not using WordPress, it's really important for your site. And for the WordPress, there are many options, and I will show you the best that I'm using currently, which is really good. And if I just put cache, you will see many options. Like this one, B3 Total Cache, LiteSpeed Cache. Also this one, BWP Optimize. Also another one, BWP Fasted Cache. But this one is the best for me, and I will show you why. So just let's install it. Okay, it's installed, but not activated yet. Just I want to show you something. Just go to the directory of the WordPress files. You can see this is the files, the root directory. If you check on this one, HT access, if you are using Apache. In the case you're using Nginx, the Super Cache plugin will tell you what to do to modify the configuration. As you can see, this is the default HT access that comes in Apache sites for WordPress. Look at this. When I activate the plugin will add more rules on here. So we will see it. So I will just activate it. Refresh the page. Here's some warnings that you should follow. In my case, I am using a localhost, that's why. If I check, you can see it's not modified yet. But if I go to here, settings, Super Cache. You can see the caching is off. I will put this one, caching on. And I think it will add the new rules for Apache. For the HT access. Let me see. Not yet. Let me go to advanced. I will go to this expert, update the status. There it is, and there it is. You can see all the new rules in the HT access file. What it does is it will tell the server to read first the generated static file. That's why the cache will be really fast, because it will not depend on PHP. It will read directly the HTML files. So that's why I'm not sure if the other cache have this option, but I tested and this plugin has it, and the speed is increased really big, so the site is really fast because it's just using HTML, the generated HTML, and it's fast. Okay, we can test it. Just for example, I will navigate, for example, here. You need to be logged out. For example, I'm using an incognito mode in order to generate the static HTML files. For example, I will go to this post. You can see on here, it's the URL. This post doesn't have a category, that's why I'm categorized. And if I go to the files, if you go to BWP content, you will see under cache folder, you will see the super cache folder, and you will see the main domain of the site, which is this. You can see here the index file. Also here in the category, you will see this, the index HTML for that post. And you can see it's also, it requires, I didn't mention that, it requires the permalink to be custom on this one. So the plugin will ask you to do that. So it's okay. As we saw, the HTML is generated. And how you can test this is basically what happens if I just put this one. I will put this one. Testing. Look at this. For example, if I add some change on the HTML, for example, I'm here stopping all the site, but our site will be not affected just for the cache, the pages that are cached. For example, here, you can see it's loading no matter what happens, it's loading. So that's why, but for example, if I just deactivate the cache feature, you can see in the admin is stopping that. Anyway, you can see, let me check, enable cache. It will work the same as you saw in the admin section testing, because now there's no cache, and you will see it will just stop all the sites with that command. Okay, and I will enable the cache. It's loading fine. I will again just test with this. And you can see it's working no matter what. So the cache is only loading the HTML file, which is good, which is what I want for my site. And I'm not sure if the other ones have that. I think not. For example, I tested the, I will remove this one. Let me check. Cache. I'm not sure if the other ones have this feature, but I was testing this one, for example, and no matter what the cache is enabled, it was loading PHP files. And I think that's it. For me, at the moment, I'm using just this one. It works really well, as I demonstrated. And if you have any question, just let me know. Also, you can tell me if other Cache plugins do the same or not. So we can learn together. Thank you for your attention.